je t'embrasse, plus j'aime t'embrasser.
Plus All right, big question you haven't asked, Ellery.
There's a big question I haven't asked, and I've been dying to ask, which is about sexuality and online dating, and which does bring up a very specific kind of parameter of online dating, where apparently there are a lot of people out there who are looking for hookups right off the bat. So how do we deal with that, and how can you finesse a situation like that?
Well, I think firstly there are many websites that allow, that lend themselves just to that. So if someone's looking for a hookup, they can go towards someone else who's also looking for a hookup. Mm. The problem is when there's a disconnect. You're not looking for to meet somebody and have a sexual relationship or be a, you know, travel companion with them on a sexual level, or, you know, a buddy, so to sexual buddy, so to speak. You're looking for a relationship and there's a disconnect. How do you find that out? Right? You find that out pretty early on, I think, if you're willing to really look at the signs and be in reality and be very aware. For instance, someone might say, oh, what are you wearing now? Or be overly seductive very early, or let's do this, or let's go to, you know, a strip club on a first date. These are all signs for people that are willing to recognize that that's not appropriate for them, right? So your job is to try to connect with people that are like-minded, that have similar values, that are appropriate for you, that allow intimacy to develop in a normal way. Sexuality can come into the, you know, people can have sex after a first date, and maybe they've learned that they're sexually compatible, but that's all they've learned. Because they don't know each other, and the next day they're going to be just as awkward as if they hadn't had sex, right? If not more so. So I really do recommend that if you're dating and you want intimacy and sexuality to be part of your relationship, that you just let that unfold in a much more organic way. You know, flirting is important. I mean, that's something that people don't do. Seduction, overt seduction, is not flirting. Attraction that people genuinely feel, having a sense of humor, being playful, having fun together, recognizing, wow, this could be exciting. You know, there's a sense of immediacy when I think people want to hook up, and they're pretending that it's really not that. So I think you just have to be very aware of what it is you're looking for.
Well, it's one way to kind of weed out the chaff, I guess, a little bit.
Absolutely.
If you realize that's the pending question that's about to be popped.
Right. And you can say, that's not for me. But I'm sure you'll find many places where your needs can be met, but that's not exactly what I'm looking for.
Right.
Or, you know, you can always say, I understand that, but that's not what I want.
Well, I mean, yeah, and it's, many of us in the realized demographic are coming from an era where, you know, we weren't available that quickly. And I think there is a level of kind of flirting which incorporates that resistance and that denial. And also, I wonder...
There's some fears, too, about sexuality.
Of course.
Ages, so.
But I think there are also probably what you could recognize. There are fears on both sides. There are fears for the women. There are fears for the men, too. And, you know, so men... being expected to be seductive and, you know, quasi-predatory or whatever.
Absolutely.
You know, there's a built-in kind of set of expectations that need to be defused.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I think that's a myth.
Yeah.
I think that's a very, very good point.
I think a lot of men would agree with that.
And men would be thrilled about that. They're men with sexual dysfunctions. They're women that are terrified that people haven't dated, or their sex life in a marriage that was failing didn't work, and so they're very fearful.
Right.
And so people need to feel emotionally safe together and happy before they even embark on that sometimes.
So don't feel afraid to just kind of go, hey, let's take it easy, you
Absolutely.
Know? And probably it'll like open things up a bit, and everyone will be more relaxed.
Absolutely. I think it creates a bit more romance.
Romance,
you know, that's a wonderful thing, and a sense of excitement about the future, isn't about the sex. It isn't about just one-night gratification. It's about developing a meaningful connection that includes sexuality, playfulness, that takes into account anxiety, past relationships, and somehow working through them together, because there's so many parts of the relationship, including the sex that could be fireworks between you.
Mm-hmm.
Right? People are often very surprised, you know, they could be 70 years old and the best sex of their lives.
All right.
It's about sensuality. It's not just about sex as it was at, say, 20 in the mm-hmm. 20s or when it was so readily available. So, yeah, I think it needs to be looked at in a very integrated way and not be thrown off by all that overt pressure.
Well, also, it brings up again the topic of sex, you know, over 50, over 60, over whatever. Theoretically, if you're in an online dating situation and you're starting to meet new people, you could look at it as an opportunity to redefine yourself. Because so many people have gone through experiences and marriages and maybe felt wounded or slightly traumatized or things didn't work out and there have been disappointments. I mean, another way to look at the dating thing is like, wow, I want to get out there and try it again. I'm not going to give up. And
I think that's a wonderful use of your time to look at it like that.
Yeah, I mean, it's a chance for you to develop a new, perception of yourself.
Absolutely.
Actually,
right. If you do it in that way, there's no way you could lose out.
You exactly.
will only benefit and feel more alive, which in turn makes you feel more interesting, which then connects you to other people, but also in the moment growing and learning, and sexuality is being weaved in it. It isn't the one thing to avoid or be anxious about.
Mm-hmm, right.
So true.
Yeah. So go out there and date more. Feel free.
Absolutely. I would agree with you. And I there's a little quote here that I have, which I wanted to just mention, by Walt Whitman. It says, "Happiness not in another place, but this place. Not for another hour, but this hour." So every dating hour and every dating evening, try to be fully there, not thinking, what does he or she think of me?
Right.
How am I lacking? How are they lacking? Try to just live with another human being. Where else are you going to be? You chose to do this. You're doing it in a really mindful, creative, and safe way, and you can only benefit when you do it like that.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
That's what I'd encourage.
Okay. Well, also, if you're going to get out there and do all this, the ABCs of Dating, Guide to Love and Dating for the Open-Hearted, which I think is a lovely way, it's a lovely caveat, the open-hearted, because that means you're open to all kinds of experience. And thank you very much, Brenda, for opening our eyes and our hearts to these new ideas.
Thank you so much. It's my pleasure to be affiliated and to be here at Realize. And please, you know, check in and for more.
Oh yeah, and if you have questions, she'll answer them.
I will.
You can just write us.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I'd love to. I get inspired by what the questions from the from the readers are, and it stimulates more interesting discussions between Ellery and for what the readers are looking for. So go ahead, go out there.
Come on down. Okay, great.
Thanks. Thank you. That was great. Good job.
Plus je t'embrasse, plus j'aime t'embrasser, plus je t'enlace, plus j'aime t'enlacer. Le temps qui passe ne peut rien y changer. Mon cœur bat quand tu t'en vas, mais tout va bien.